Most USB drives come out of the package ready to go. But there may come a time when you want to erase data off the drive, or maybe you have a flash drive that works on a PC but not on a Mac and you'd like it to be the other way around. Let's format that USB drive step by step. This is DIY in 5. Hey everyone, my name is Trisha Hirschberger and you are watching DIY in 5. The show where we make tech tasks easy enough that you can DIY them. Today, we are going to learn how to format a USB drive, prepping it to organize your data and maximize space for your files. So let's get started. Windows users, you're up first. Insert a USB drive into a USB port on your PC. Open File Explorer, click on This PC from the left panel. Under Devices and Drives, right-click the flash drive and select the Format option. Under the File System drop-down menu, you'll see a variety of formatting options. Let's quickly break down the most common so you know which to choose for your needs. FAT32 is the Windows default for USB drives with a capacity of 32 gigabytes and less. Is recognized by both Mac and Windows, but offers no security and caps files at 4 gigabytes in size. This is what most USB drives have out of the box. exFAT has no file size limit, is compatible with both Windows and Mac, but older systems might require an update to read and write to this format. NTFS is what Windows uses by default for internal drives running the operating system or in use as a secondary drive. It has a much larger max file size, but is read-only on macOS without a third-party utility. macOS Extended is the native solution for Mac users, has max file size capabilities, and won't work on a PC without a third-party tool. Finally, APFS is another macOS system, which includes features like cloning and file-level encryption, but won't work with a PC without a third-party tool. So, choose whichever file format is best for you from the dropdown, and carry on. In the Allocation Unit Size drop-down menu, use the default selection. In the Volume Label field, confirm a drive name that will appear in File Explorer. For example, Kingston USB. Under the Format Options section, select either Quick Format or Full Format. Quick Format will delete the file system table and root folder. It's efficient, but not the most secure. Full Format will scan for bad sectors and write zeros in all sectors, which deletes all data permanently, but takes a bit longer depending on the capacity of the drive. Once you've made your selection, click the Start button, click Yes, and you are ready to go. Now for the Mac users. Insert a USB drive into your USB port. Launch Disk Utility from Applications, Utilities, Disk Utility. Select the USB drive from the list on the left and select Erase at the top. Select the file system or format that you'd like, remember we covered these earlier, and you should see the options listed there. Note, if you're using macOS 10.13 High Sierra or newer, and you do not see APFS on the list, click Cancel. Go to the View menu and select Show All Devices. Select the new device that will now appear higher in the logical device tree, which will be named something with both upper and lowercase letters, and click Erase again. Then, from the Scheme drop-down menu, select GUID Partition Map. Next, click on the Format drop-down and APFS should become available for you to select. Now, once you have your chosen format selected, type in a name for the drive. Select Erase, then select Done once complete. At this point, you're good to go. If this video helped you format your USB drive successfully, give us a like and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on any future tech tips. If you ran into a hiccup and got caught up along the way, let us know in the comments and hopefully we can all help each other out. All right, thanks for watching everyone, and I will see you next time with more DIY in 5.